Ebony.
It has a nice...
I mean, it's oddly strange how... I mean, vastly different.
Yeah.
They are. The question I have for you is... So that's something you've learned from experience of, you know, obviously building the guitars and working with the guitars, that the tone is... percentage of the tone is in the neck, right?
You said there was a scientist that did a study on this,
yeah,
right?
It's a German scientist, and he made a book about 1,000 pages and tell you everything on an instrument you can forget, important is the neck.
Oh.
I think that makes sense.
In a certain way, it makes sense, yes. And when we take a guitar, you know, where you have, end of the day, everything is done on physics. So there's the side is swinging, and the tone wood tries to start as well to swing, and to the less it's itself vibrating,
right,
the less the more sustain you have. So when you have, for example, if you would have a piece of marble and put a string on it, the sustain will be endless because the marble is not starting to move.
Right.
That's
interesting. And so the wood is absorbing it.
Yeah.
Right.
And that is giving you then the tone.
Mm-hmm.
So when you make, it's vibrating, and when it's vibrating, you know, this area here, the neck, of course, because it's the longest part. And then you have this short part which is going into the body, but it's very stiff. So the most vibrations are happening here.
I never thought of it that way. He's right. I never thought of it. I never looked at it as right. 3/4 of the string's distance is on top of the neck. So I can see why that would have more.
And of course, all the small things are coming into it. So it means. With the bridge system, what bridge system you have on. Also, I think a little bit the mass of the body.
We're live.
All right, we're live.
We're live.
Marcus, how are you? Please. Dude.
Oh, see, almost left you hanging. There you go.
So what are we talking about, Marcus? Why don't you introduce yourself for those that don't know who you are?
I'm Marcus. I'm, guitar, doctor specialist here for Framus and Warwick.
We would say he's
and
the man.
Yeah.
I'm taking care of the production and everything what belongs to Framus and Warwick.
Yeah.
So from forklift driving to service questions. Yeah, everything.
Now, production. Just to be clear, for those on my channel, we saw Vivian, the V. He was the guy behind the whole thing. And we also did the Phil-X, you were behind the Phil-X that I got at GitCon.
Yeah.
I'm trying to think, I have an idol maker. So all of those, you had your hands in. Yeah. But probably more the V than anything else, because that was a very custom guitar.
Yeah.
And he was the guy I was talking to over the phone, over email. And
then we made it happen with
And
our
we made
team.
It happen, yeah. Absolutely. So.
And for me, we did my 32-inch scale Warwick bass.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yep. Yeah.
Which is my only bass I play.
Yeah,
that's it.
So he's the guy.
He's the guy.
He's the guy. All right. So what are we talking about today?
We are talking about fretboard woods, or about tone woods, and especially on the fretboard woods, the rosewood.
Okay.
I have here a small selection of different kind of woods. Like here we have maple. Here we have siricotti. We have here ebony. We have here white ebony. And the other species are rosewood species. So now. Your selection.
Mm-hmm.
What is the Brazilian rosewood?
So I have to pick the Brazilian rosewood.
You have to pick the Brazilian.
You taught me something before. So I'm going to do something that's going to be odd to you, but hang on. We'll explain it in a second.
Don't say your answer yet. Don't say yes or no. Just smell it and get the idea.
I don't think this is it.
Okay, let me see. I agree. I don't think that's it either.
This is it. This is the Brazilian rosewood.
See, you weren't supposed to say, but let's see. Okay, ready? Oh, yeah. not even. Yeah. Makes me want an ice cream cone.
I know. So what we learned was Brazilian rosewood, which is very rare, right?
Yep.
You can't get that today.
It's since 92 on the red list.
Yep.
And you don't get it anymore.
It has an overwhelming aroma of vanilla. Why is that?
Yeah.
I don't know. I cannot tell you, but that's most of the time when you compare, for example, these two woods, you know, if this would be a little bit darker, you could say it has a kind of the same structure like Brazilian rosewood.
Mm-hmm. Right.
But the only reason how you get it, or how you get it easily, besides testing under microscope, mm-hmm. you
smell it.
Smell on it. And this smells completely different.
This smells woody. It smells like wood. It doesn't smell like vanilla.
But it also has an taste.
Can you smell this one again?
Yeah. This is the wood. Yeah.
Smells like wood, right?
Yeah, like when you get like a milk crate or anything where the wood's exposed.
Like a cedar.
Cedar smells like wood.
Yep.
So.
This is, I love this. This just smells so good.
I was told that when a fretboard is made, and fretted already, I've seen like master luthiers and they always scratch a little bit and smell it to like kind of release that odor. Is that what they're doing? They're releasing the vanilla?
Yeah.
Scratch and sniff.
Yeah, because it's silly. I wouldn't have thought anything of it the first time I saw it. But the second time I saw a totally different master luthier do it that didn't know the other one. And the question was, is that, you know, Brazilian? And he went, yeah, no. You know what I mean? And it was weird to me to see that. So now your explanation makes a lot of sense.
Now, we were doing, before we got the camera on, we were tapping the woods.
Yeah.
So
this we can do also on those.
Tell us what we're looking for.
So,
here.
Well, this is up to the taste, what you want to have. We have here, for example, Cocobolo. Cocobolo is it belongs also to the rosewood species,
mm-hmm.
but it has a very strong structure and it's very heavy. So you have on this one more heights, more brightness.
Right.
And a longer sustain. Then you have ebony, then you have the rosewood. Rosewood is much wider. It has an longer sustain and also the tone is a bit warmer. So these are the things what you can hear a little bit by when you tap the tone woods. And you take 1/3 like this and then you tap with your thumb. And then you hear how the tonal.
So you said about 1/3?
Yeah.
Down.
And then with the thumb.
Using the side, right?
Yeah.
Like a bass player.
Yeah. Yeah. Like a bass player.
Wow. It sounds like a cajun or a conga or something. Right?
Yeah.
Like a wood chime or something.
Yeah.
So this is very bright when you listen to it, and this is more warmer.
But this is louder. I mean...
Yeah, this is also...
I mean, maybe a little bit...
Hang on, let me do this one real quick. Okay, and this is the Brazilian?
Yeah. Now, Cocobolo, is that on the sides?
Yes.
Okay, because it's a type of rosewood, it's part of the...
Yeah.
Okay, well, and we'll get to CITES later, but yes, I just wanted to make sure that was key on the list.
Ebony?
That one has a nice...
I mean, it's oddly strange how, I mean, vastly different.
Yeah.
They are. That's the ebony?
That
one. Also, how much dramatically more heavy the
ebony definitely.
Is.
Yeah.
Okay. Wow.
That's just maple, yeah. And you hear it's completely different.
It's so light, too.
Yeah.
Oh, it's very... The whole piece of wood is, like, resonating.
Yeah, this feels almost like the balsa. Yeah, but it really is.
Very resonant.
It almost feels more alive. You know what I mean? Like, I don't know how to explain that. But yeah.
Yeah, it's you know, it's also with tapping, it's difficult to explain what are the difference, because I think also to describe a tone, it's always difficult where you say... When you don't measure it, when you only hear it, then you say, okay, this is more, it's more warmer, more, my opinion, more lower mids.
Right.
And yeah, these are the tone woods what you can select, you know.
Right.
And this is also sometimes what selection you want to have on the instrument. End of the day, you have to bring everything together, because you have the neck, you have the fretboard, and of course the body, but we can start this discussion. The body is, in my opinion, not the biggest part of the tone of the instrument.
Yeah.
All right. So, Marcus, thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Yes, dude.
I did it again.
I have to wait. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.
And thank you for watching this video. Give you one of those. We'll see you later.